should we define custom semantic conventions to use across our large organization? This is a thread that I came across on the observability subreddit. It reads, "Hi, we're considering creating our own custom semantic conventions which are relevant to our own organization for internal teams to use, so naming is consistent for OTel across the enterprise. To do this, we're looking to create some jars, DLLs, etc., with the compiled attributes similar to what is done in the OTel jars. I can't find anything in the OTel docs, the OpenTelemetry docs, suggesting this is a good approach, so I was just wondering if anyone else is doing this or any reason not to do this." Honestly, it's a really, really good question, and it's a question that comes up quite a lot at the customers that I work with. Should we standardize on OTel? Should we do our own thing? What's the best case here? My first advice, and the default advice, without knowing who this individual is or the company they work for, is don't. Don't roll your own. Use the standards. Why? Well, first of all, you're probably reinventing the wheel. The OpenTelemetry standards, semantic conventions, are enormous, and they cover pretty much anything that you're going to want to do. That's not to say, of course, that there's never a situation. I'm not going to say that. If you're doing something really, really specific and internal that is only relevant to your organization, then maybe. But two things there. One, I would be surprised if that's true. And two, the OpenTelemetry project are actually really willing, and they're good, and they're willing to accept contributions to the semantic conventions. I did that with cost and ownership information. As I say, I think if you dig deep enough, what you're trying to achieve will probably already exist in the spec in some way, shape, or form, or you can leverage parts of the spec for what you're trying to achieve. The next reason is cross-vendor support. So this company, again, I don't know them, don't know who this is, but they're probably using or relying on other companies to achieve some sort of, you know, business goal. For example, let's take a database. Let's imagine we've rolled our own and we call ours database underscore type, and it's equal to Redis or Cassandra or something. Now, let's imagine our third-party vendor who we rely on follows the OTel conventions and they use db.system. Well, now we've got two attributes in our logs, in our spans, and ultimately two attributes in the backend. So we're going to need to map those together. And any time you need to map something together, human error or forgetfulness, or, you know, step forward 5 years and you will have forgotten that you did that. So you need to maintain that. The next reason is related to the backend, actually. Ultimately, you're going to push your OpenTelemetry data somewhere. And think about it, that backend, if you send a logline with db.system equals Redis, that backend can be smart. It knows that you've just got a new, it's seeing a new database, and that database is actually a Redis database. So whatever smarts they have in the backend, you know, they can pop up a new tile that says, we've just found a new Redis, and here are the specific metrics about Redis, and here are the specific thresholds and alerts and all that kind of thing, purely for Redis. Whereas if you do your own thing and send db underscore type, the backend won't know without that mapping. So in summary, no, probably not. Don't roll your own, don't do your own thing, don't take on that extra work. If this was helpful, or if you have observability questions that you'd like me to answer, please do drop them in the comments below and I'll take a look. Until next time, bye.